comes to seasonal candy, some people love candy corn and some people would rather just well give it away to whoever's around. But when it comes to Maria's Next Treats, I promise they will be a big hit with everybody, whether you love candy corn or not, right?
And they're so cute.
Well, there you go. That's what it comes down to. Maria, welcome to the kitchen. This is exciting for me.
Thank you.
Allie, Orly, Shirley are at the counter and they've got their plate of goodness
ready
to snack.
I love candy corn.
How about these guys?
I'm a candy corn fan, so I'm all about this.
Candy corn fan. Let's go through it. Orly?
Yeah. Huge fan.
Yeah? You love candy corn?
Yeah.
I've got a confession before I get your answer. I'm not a big candy corn guy.
Nobody's surprised. Nobody's surprised by
that. I'm not a big. It's not my thing. It's
when
not what I'm doing.
Floats in a bowl of bone broth.
Well,
would you sip
listen,
it?
I love ice cream. That's not Cameron-ish. What about you, Maria?
I have zero self-control when it comes to candy corn.
Really?
If I have one, I eat the whole bag. I either have to have one and commit or I can't have it at all.
Wow.
Okay.
So that's why the meringue is really great for those who love or who don't love candy corn because, one, it's really beautiful, but it's not your traditional candy corn in the sense of it being, you know, what we think of, what we get in the store. We have that wonderful marshmallowy, sort of crunchy, gourmet version of this. And we put it on a stick, so it's like a lollipop.
It's like a lollipop. And you know, lots of oohs and ahs over on the counter, so we're off to a good start. Now, you mentioned meringues already. So, obviously, one of the things when you're as experienced in making meringues as I am, that you got to be worried is getting those egg whites, you know, whipped just right. So, what's the key?
What are we looking for? This is, so, like you said, the base of any meringue, there's so many different recipes and styles of meringue, but the base is always egg whites and sugar.
Yeah, okay.
Our style that we're doing today is more of a French style. So what you're looking for initially is for Cameron to move his arm so I can lift this up. And so this is...
We're off to a good start, Matheson. All right.
So you can see this is kind of foamy. These are egg whites, and just a pinch of salt. And you want to beat it up so it starts to get soft peaks, so just a little foamy.
Okay, so we're not there yet.
We're not there yet. Okay, so I'll turn this off so we can chat. So what we have here, we have our sugar. So what you're looking for in terms of sugar, this is called baker's sugar. It's a finer grain sugar, kind of between a powdered sugar and a regular sugar. You need this to make a perfect meringue because you want it to dissolve into the egg whites. And it's usually like, in terms of ratio, like a 1-to-2 ratio.
Egg whites to sugar?
Yes.
So one egg white for two.
Yeah, basically, so it's like half a cup of egg whites and a cup plus two tablespoons of sugar. So anyways, and also I'm going to add in some other things for stability.
Okay, so that's what I was going to ask next. Like, because sometimes meringues can just be a little bit like a wah-wah.
Yeah,
and you got to make it like have a little more life.
So make them not wah-wah. What I have here, it's a technical term. You need to add acidity. So what I have for my acidity here, you could do a lemon juice. You could do, I already got it in there. So you could do lemon juice. You could do a vinegar, but I'm using cream of tartar. What it does is it adds stability to the egg whites.
Okay.
And it gives it body. It's going to give it something to hold on to. And the reason you want to, I like cream of tartar because I feel like it's foolproof and you only need a very little bit. Actually, can you have this running?
Jeez, I'm 0 for 2. Wow.
And so this is what I recommend. You mix it all together in here. Oh, sorry. Before I do that, I'm going to add in my vanilla.
And I was waiting for.
No, you can keep mixing. And so what... you want to do. You want your liquids all mixed together, then you add in your sugar. Okay, so this is what we have here. And I want to make sure we have enough time. You want to do this very, very slowly. And I'm going to add it all
but
in just
today.
For time. Not today, but you would do that all very slowly.
You would do it slower than
slowly
that.
If you do this. But you want to keep beating this up, and you want to make sure that your sugar gets dissolved and it holds those really glossy, beautiful, stiff peaks.
Okay.
How do you know?
We're going to keep this running.
How do you know when it's all dissolved?
So what you want to do, actually, you would do this, and I just want to... Three for zero. Wait, what is there? What's your?
Where are you at? 3.
0 for 3. So what you want to do is you actually want to do, you want to put it between your fingers like this.
Yeah.
If it feels grainy, Cameron, do you want to try it? If it feels grainy, then you want to keep mixing.
It feels a little grainy.
It feels grainy.
Yeah.
Okay.
This is my favorite segment ever.
I have to give him a hard time. Okay, so we're going to keep mixing here. And then we have our beautiful, luxurious meringue right here.
Okay, so this is what we will get out of that,
exactly.
Right?
Exactly. Egg becomes light and fluffy and like this.
Okay,
and
good.
So now we color it.
Yep.
And obviously we want to do our candy corn colors. I want to do a gel food coloring.
Okay.
And the reason I do gel cam is because
Versus liquid.
Yep. You don't want to add in any more liquid at this point because then it might not potentially dry out the way you want it to dry out in the oven. So you mix it all up, but let's swap over so we can show how to make it.
It's very vibrant.
It's very, very vibrant. So what I'm going to do
I feel like I can turn this off now.
Yeah,
is that okay?
That's okay. And Thanks for asking. Yeah. So this is going to hold our parchment
for permission. Yes.
We are holding the parchment paper down by adding a little bit of the meringue down there like that. And so, Cam, I'm going to show you. So what we have here.
So we've mixed our three colors.
Yeah.
I'm going to take the orange, so and we're doing the base first.
Do the bottom first. Like this. And actually, I can pass it over to you if you want.
Oh, I see.
We'll switch.
Okay.
And so what you do is you do your colors like this, and you go into your triangle shape. I'll pass
Is that too much?
Over. No, it's perfect.
Okay.
And you don't want it to be too thin either. You want it to be like have some substantial like, and then you have this. And actually, I'm gonna add a little bit more here. And then what you do, Cam, this is the trick to meringue. I really want to make sure I tell you this. You pop it in the oven at 250 degrees, and you want to let it cook for about an hour. And what you're essentially looking for is that it's drying out.
Right.
And you want, after it's done, turn the heat off and leave your oven just cracked for a small amount of space. And then leave them alone for hours on end. Good job, Cameron.
Yes.
And because the reason why you want to do that is essentially you are wanting your meringue to dry out. You're not necessarily baking it. So if you don't do that and your meringue's sticky, then that means you didn't let
Guess which? Just guess real quick. Which is which?
Oh.
I know that one was yours. And
that's mine.
Yes.
Thanks very much.
I like.
I have one last question. As you pipe them, are they going to puff up in the oven, or what you see is what it's going to look
What you see is what it's going to look like. They will not puff up because they're, even though you're adding an acidity, it's not reacting to anything. So it's not going to puff in that way.
Right.
So that is, you know, what you see is what you get.
Can I just say this, honestly? This is so creative and so unique and pretty darn cool. Way to go. Yeah.
You did a good job, Cameron.
Thank you so much.
So yummy. Yeah. Thank you so much, Maria. This is so cute. For the full recipe, make sure to visit HallmarkChannel.com.